What many Kenyans will ask me, why Turkana, why not other places? Other places, work is being done, but this initiative cannot address the needs of every corner of this country. From the food point of view, we might do it that, but from the long to mid-term, we might have to look as an example to say this village in Kaikor, never again should this situation persist. And I hope this initiative will achieve that. The situation is real. The situation needs to be arrested immediately. And we need to find mid to long-term solution to address this very problem. And we need to find mid to long-term solution to address this very problem. The challenges that everyone asks is why Turkana, why Wajir, why Moyale, why these areas? And is this the forgotten land that we talk about Kenya? And I was extremely happy yesterday that Mugo Kibati, the director of Vision 2030, was with us in this trip. And I think it was even an eye-opener for him to have then seen this other side of Kenya. That every 2 years, 3 years cycle, we go back over and over. And a lot of you are asking, why do you go over and over? You as humanitarian actors and players, are you perpetuating this? And this is a question that I've been asked by many people. And I say to all of them, that probably, and people also ask me, what has the government done? And I don't think I want to talk about government or about apportioning blame to anybody. Fundamentally, yes, the government has a responsibility, but all of us have a responsibility in one form or another. That these are areas that are marginalized, that are the least developed in our country, but as that video showed, and as the private sector corporate leaders who went there yesterday, the media owners, also saw that it is actually possible to turn around those areas to become farmlands that can produce enough for the population out there, but even much more to sell to other parts of Kenya. That the current breadbasket of Kenya can be your export market, but these are the Kenya that we all know of nothing but misery, and they're dependent on livestock that are not even good quality. The chair of Kenya Meat Commission just left, but if you look at the number of animals in that area, the numbers are too big, they're very weak, they don't produce enough milk, neither enough meat. And we need to do something even about that.
I've been astonished about the debate about whether people were dying or weren't dying and how many people were dead. This is not about whether people were dying or not. Yesterday, a number of us went to Turkana, and we didn't see anybody die. We didn't see anyone die. What we saw was a death of dignity. And you saw in the video, we saw men who should be standing proud. We saw them on their knees. We saw them unable to stand for themselves. And whilst we debate about whether people died, and whilst we spend media money to defend a position, people were losing their dignity in Turkana. And I believe that they're losing their dignity in other parts of the country. Last Saturday, I was in West Pokot, and I also saw people losing their dignity. And ladies and gentlemen, we got on the flight and we came home and we were a little bit down. But you know, the thing which lifted our spirits was the fact that we saw young men and women who were there, Abbas, you know, these guys are living in amongst the community, helping, distributing the money which so far, I think 350,000 Kenyans have donated over the past week.
Basically, I think the response has been very good. On behalf of Equity, let me confirm. On Wednesday, we received an amount of 260 million shillings from DFID to distribute in that region, 4,300 shillings. To 60,000 families, and that distribution has been going on for the last 3 days. I would like to really take this opportunity for that initiative by UKAID, FID, and partners to really make that contribution. This is a program that has been going on. Every 2 months, we pay $2,150 to each of the 60,000 families, but this time they decided to double the amount to $4,300. So that really, the second one is really has have been challenged, and I really liked Michael, the question of addressing the issue of Northern Kenya so that every year we don't need to be sitting here to make donations. Equity has really decided to invest in that region. We have opened 11 branches in the 13 districts, and that we are now starting to see the impact you could make by introducing really entrepreneurship and commercial aspects. It's not just necessarily looking on from the government. And tomorrow, I'm happy to say, our MasterCard Foundation president is here, and at Lodwar, at Takana, we'll be graduating 2,000 entrepreneurs we want to empower financially so that the opportunity, the challenge becomes an opportunity where the private sector is. I would really like to invite the media association to join us so that you can see long-lasting solutions are coming into place. This second one, of course, I'm not here to defend the government. I'm not in the government. But as chairman of Vision 2030, I just want to say that the blueprint, and I'm happy to say Mogo Kibati joined the team yesterday. It was unfortunate last minute I couldn't join. I'd been given a seat. The vision is focusing on Northern Kenya. And when people read here about the Lamu Corridor project, it's literally to open that region, and fully that region will be open. When you put a resort center in Turkana, when you put a resort center in Isioro, that really means that you are giving the private sector the infrastructure to open that area. So we are hoping, as the president has directed, the road and the railway will commence by early next year, because that is the lasting solution for that area, so that the private sector can do the less. So a lot of let me also confirm, we at Vision 2030, the government this week released 2.3 billion shillings for 13 small-scale irrigation schemes in the affected 13 districts. So the government is also doing a lot. And as you know, the vote for irrigation this year is 10.5 billion shillings. And all of the these projects are partially, substantially in Northern Kenya. Irrigation will completely change Northern Kenya. Those who know, Abbas mentioned it, we decided to take up and rehabilitate Bura Irrigation as Equity Bank, gave loans of about 230 million, and increased the yield in that region, or Bura Irrigation, from 4 bags per acre to 31 bags per acre. And now we have introduced cotton. And these are the solutions that will solve the issues of Northern Kenya. However, we need to deal with the immediate need today. It's all about, we're working with Abbas and Bob and Hopufre. We are making arrangements to get the whole 7 million equity customers to participate. We have already opened the account, so hopefully in the next 2 weeks we should be able to see what they have been able to, such that it is easy transfer. But for equity, we want to really do the cash today. And as Martin said, equity, I want to confirm what Martin said, that equity has overtaken KCB in size. So essentially, even in planning, it appears in our ambition to support this Martin, we are slightly above 7.5 million. I'll ask Bob and Buzz to come and take the check from Mary so that it's in cash. Martin, please take care of this money. We are wearing it this afternoon so that we can have the food starting to go tomorrow. A donation of 20 million Kenya shillings.
Julie and Jeff, thank you. You're doing great. I've just, this event, we have moved it to the rest of the world. Our Kenyans abroad are participating. Instantly, they are watching me, they are on us. And don't wonder how it is happening, but it's happening. They are asking Can we volunteer doctors to this region? I think it's something we, the corporate world, should look at it. If it's possible, they want also to know. They are also asking for that song from that was sung here, Kilio. If they can get it, I'm sure we are going to put it in our digital media and they can download it. Finally, they are asking, after all this money is spent, can they have the final accounts certified to confirm it was used for what it was? We in Capital Media, we're not the biggest. When the guitar here and my friend are there, we play the back role. But we are an effective, focused, small media. We talk to the people with the cash, and I hope they are helping to bring money. And that's why we were playing the role of digital connectivity to the rest of the world. Capital does that, and is doing that right now. We are involved. As you know, I wear many hats besides the one I got today. And most all these companies are participating. They are collecting money, and they are participating in doing other empowerment, because we feel this ritual of collecting money for Kenyans must stop. We must empower Kenyans. We must grow food. If we have to get the Israelis, let's do so. To go there to the desert, they know how to grow food in the desert. Today I came with the two companies' pledges. The rest will be doing it, and they have been doing it. Centum is an investment company that we own. It's a public company, and I like my friend to come up here and receive a donation from Centum of 500,000 shillings. That's 500,000 shillings. And you stay here. Most of these people, the biggest thing they need right now is something to get their health back. At HACO, we have a product called Movite, which has over 11 vitamins. It has got many, many empowering items, including things like selenium, iodine, zinc, and you need to get this product pronto to the region to save lives of kids who have been totally malnourished. And for that, HACO is contributing 3.6 million shillings worth of this product. Well done. I do hope you give us a report on how that product has done, because we believe we need to save lives. And we need to make sure this issue of survival does not exist. Turkanas are Kenyans. Why should they not be empowered as you empower the rest of Kenyans? Thank you very much.
Thank you.